Discretion is advised.
Mama Black.
This program contains language and sequences some viewers may find disturbing.
Right!
Good evening again. The victim seeing the brazen break-in unfold live on his smartphone while he was out to lunch.
It's a Night Team exclusive. The crook's getting away with hundreds of dollars in electronics. The Night Team Sheldon Fox live in Miami with a story you will see on Just One Station. Sheldon?
And they went into every room, Belkis and Jeff. They went through many drawers. They stole iPads. They stole laptop computers. And they stole jewels. But at least these people had the presence of mind to have their cameras rolling, and at least they would know that every move was recorded. In comes trouble by the pair, burglars, one of whom gets a security camera close-up during a Miami broad daylight lunchtime caper off of North Miami Avenue.
I was currently at work on my lunch break when I received a notification on my phone via my personal home security system alerting me that there was some movement in my home. And when I saw the footage on my telephone, I noticed that it was someone that I did not recognize.
The anonymous homeowner showed his surveillance footage to 7 and explained how the heist was partially halted, even though nobody was home during the crime.
Once I realized that someone was actually robbing my home, I hit the siren.
And so the crooks made their way in through this back window here. They used the homeowner's handheld shovel to do it. And once on the inside, they were all alone, so they thought, with nothing but things to steal in front of them. They ended up taking $5,000 worth of goods. But the only problem for these two is that they were caught on camera while doing it, being monitored the whole time live by the homeowner on his cell phone. After triggering his alarm,
I called the police immediately.
The noise didn't seem to rattle the burglars, who eventually left. Soon after that, the area of 46th Street, North Miami Avenue, flooded with City of Miami police hunting for crooks, but no dice. Not yet.
My blood was boiling. That's what was going on in my head, you know. And I felt very violated as I'm looking at the footage of these guys inside of my house, taking things, casually.
But at least one of them made himself available for everybody to clearly see. Crime scene investigators, detectives, and canines were all over the block right where we're standing earlier today. 7 News cameras were here rolling as well. Pick up the phone call, Crime Stoppers, if you recognize this guy or know anything about what happened earlier today around 1 o'clock. It was two guys. They both wore hoodies, and they took a lot of that stuff that we showed you. 305-471-TIPS, the number to Crime Stoppers in Miami-Dade County. You can collect cash for the right anonymous tip and do it the right way.
Is on after a railroad security guard is killed in a shooting at a South Suburban rail yard. Eyewitness News reporter Will Jones is on the scene for us tonight in Harvey. Will?
Ravi, state police have just arrived on scene. They have taken over the scene here. The car that they're looking at, that was the car that was initially reported stolen tonight, and that's how it all began this evening. I want to start from the top. Take a look at some video. We're told by police a Harvey resident called police and said her car was stolen. The victim followed after the suspect in another car. The suspect hopped out of the vehicle at 159th and Park and ran up on the railroad tracks. That's when he came into contact with the Canadian National Railroad security officer. Investigators say the suspect fired more than a dozen shots and the security officer was hit in the stomach. After that, investigators say the man stole another car and he abandoned that car in East Hazelcrest. He took off on foot after that. Now a manhunt is underway for the man who shot and killed the security officer.
For the residents of East Hazelcrest, Hazelcrest and Markham, we want you to be on alert because he is considered to be armed and very dangerous. He was wearing a black sweatshirt, blue jeans, medium build for now. We'll get a better description as we talk to other witnesses. But for now, we want the communities on alert that he is indeed armed and very dangerous.
So we have two scenes underway right now. This is one scene. State police are looking at that car that was initially reported stolen. And then another scene that searched for the suspect. And I just want to go over the description that we have of the man they're looking for. At this point, it's very limited. He was wearing a black sweatshirt, blue jeans. He has a medium build. Again, he is considered armed and dangerous. We're live tonight in Harvey. Will Jones, ABC 7. Eyewitness News.
Following a developing story right now, charges could be coming today for the man accused of killing a security guard in South Suburban Harvey.
Yeah, CBS2's Mike Puccinelli is live at the Harvey Police Department. Closer look at how they captured him. Good morning, Mike.
Hi. Of course, this was a high-profile case, and police say the tips really never stopped coming in this one. On Thursday, police announced they were looking for Rashad Williams. They say he gunned down a security guard last weekend. They say he killed Tyrone Harden while running from officers who were chasing him in connection with a car theft. Now, Harden was working as a security guard at that time. Now, the two men had their fatal encounter when Williams ditched a stolen car and ran onto the tracks that Harden was guarding for Canadian National Railway. Witnesses reported hearing more than a dozen shots. Police say Williams also fired at someone else in addition to Harden. Investigators say the 24-year-old murder suspect was arrested late last night in Chicago Heights.
He was seen walking with grocery bags, and he was approached. He attempted to run, but he was shortly apprehended in a foot pursuit.
And police say they expect Williams to be charged with first-degree murder, possibly as soon as today. Harden will be laid to rest this upcoming weekend.
A Houston mother accused in the death of her 3-year-old son is still on the run at this hour. Police only 2 hours ago asking for your help in finding her. Eyewitness News reporter Kevin Quinn live with the latest on what that search means for this mom still on the run. Kevin?
Yeah, Art, I just hung up the phone with police right now. They are still looking for the mother of that little boy who died. She disappeared after his death.
Police need your help in locating 21-year-old Jasmine Jones. They say she disappeared after the death of her 3-year-old son. Someone called 911 from these apartments on Willcrest in West Houston November 8th. When paramedics arrived, Jason Jones was not conscious. His injuries, something even seasoned investigators say they won't soon forget.
It's probably one of the worst cases that we've seen.
The beating that boy took here, they say, was not a one-time thing. His injuries in various stages of healing, bruising to his buttocks, back, abdomen, pelvis, and head. Investigators say they didn't have enough evidence to charge Jasmine Jones at the time they discovered this. In talking to her and others, they learned the injuries that she and possibly the others inflicted was supposed to be some form of discipline for the toddler.
Having gone through it for quite some time, it's particularly rough to think that, you know, a poor innocent child could go through something like that.
Police say CPS took the child from Jasmine Jones previously and had just returned him to her 1 month before he died.
In fact, police say Jason was removed from the home for about 18 months. Police telling us following an incident where he suffered second-degree burns. His mother claimed he was scalded by hot water in the shower. We should note that there was a second girl, a little 10-month-old girl, in the home at the time the 3-year-old died. She is now in temporary custody of CPS. Police still asking for your help in locating that little boy's mother.
We first told you about this morning. Police are searching for a man they say kidnapped and raped an 11-year-old girl in Whitehaven on her way to school. It happened around 7 this morning as she was walking to Jeter Middle. WREG's Luke Jones was the first reporter on the scene this morning and spoke exclusively to that little girl's mom.
Oh,
from pure shock.
That's messed up.
To plain disgust, parents in Whitehaven rattled and disturbed by news an 11-year-old girl was raped on her way to school this morning.
We never had issues like that over here. Never ever. Not issues about rape. It was just like a family community over here.
The girl, who we're not identifying, was walking to Jeter Middle School around 7 a.m. from her home only about a mile away when a man in a blue SUV pulled up. Listen to the girl's mother describe what happened next.
Snatched her, put her in the truck, raped her, and dropped her off over here.
Here in a ditch near Delta and Manson Roads, battered and bruised, her mother says, but expected to be okay. We watched as she left in an ambulance this morning. Hours later, police still in the area and searching for the man who did this.
He's our top priority. I mean, anytime you get anything like that happening with juveniles, kids on the way to school, kids are our prized possession.
Now, parents, listen up. If you have a kid who walks to school, maybe they even walk here to Jeter, try and have them walk in groups. And that's because police say it's much harder for people to deal with groups of kids than it is for just one.
Breaking news update. We were impressed with how quickly Memphis police tracked down this accused child rapist. But tonight, they're giving the little girl all of the praise for her poise after the attack and her detailed description of suspect Larry Ward. WMC Action News 5's Jerry Askin spoke with her mother and police about her heroic behavior in the face of such terror. She joins us live. Jerry.
And that 11-year-old girl said she was walking here when she was raped and kidnapped. Tonight, her mother and MPD are applauding her for her fast thinking, which led to an arrest.
I'm just trying to cope with the whole situation.
This mother is terrified. Her 11-year-old daughter kidnapped and raped, police say, by this man, Larry Ward, who she doesn't even know, all as she was walking to Jeter Middle School early Monday morning.
It could have been worse. He could have kept her.
Thankfully, she's okay and got away safely. Now, police say after the girl was sexually assaulted here on Manson, her mother told me it was her upbringing and her quick thinking which helped police make an arrest within hours.
The more details we have, the better the chance we have of solving crime.
My daughter was able to identify the person because I made sure she learned how to focus on people that's around her, focus and identify anything.
Something she wants other parents to teach their kids. Memphis police also advising parents to warn their kids about bad strangers.
And parents need to share with their kids that it's okay to say no and to use some of those things that they do when they play, like yell real loudly and say stranger danger.
This is something that a child should never bear.
Yeah, sad story. Now, MPD Major Felicia Adams and Lieutenant Colonel Don Crow, who you saw in our story, are also parents and veterans in the MPD's Sexual Crime Bureau. As for the victim, she'll be home recovering emotionally for quite some time before she returns to school.